A portion of Hawaii's famed Kilauea volcano is more than 1,000 feet, yes, 1,000 feet higher than it was a mere 6.5 years ago. You might be wondering what exactly I'm referring to because you don't see any new towering mountains on Hawaii's big island. And you'd be right. What I'm referring to is instead Kilauea's summit caldera, which lately has been filling at an absurdly fast rate. To show you exactly what I mean, here is the same exact caldera as it stood in 2019, marking a spot where Hawaii's most active volcano lost 1,640 feet in height due to the removal of around 800 million cubic meters of molten rock, much of which ended up erupting near Leilani Estates in 2018. And now, here's the same caldera at the end of 2020, now mid-2021, 2022, 2023, 2024, and now, finally, 2025. So, exactly how much lava has Kilauea erupted in this time span, and how much has the crater floor risen by? Based on a combination of my own and US Geological Survey estimates, since the end of 2018, Kilauea's deep caldera has been filled by a maximum of 1,526 feet of fresh lava, which has a combined total volume of 305.1 million cubic meters of molten rock. Wow, so whereas Kilauea's caldera in late 2018 was for a time up to 1,821 feet deep, it is today only up to 295 feet deep. With that in mind, how long will it take for the lava lake to rise to its pre-eruption level? For this question, it truly does depend on the average rate of lava the volcano erupts each month, since it is not always actively erupting, or when it is erupting at the same rate. Here is a quick breakdown of how much lava was in place at Kilauea's summit caldera each year. For example, if we assume that Kilauea is going to continue erupting at the exact same rate that it has this month, May 2025, then lava will completely refill its youngest caldera and spill onto the wider caldera floor on May 13, 2027. A Thursday, by the way. If we expand it to the broader 2025 average, then that date is put back a few months to September 15, 2027. If we take the average since the modern trend of moderately to fully cyclical eruptions initiated on the first day of 2023, then that date falls all the way to September 14, 2033. And if we take the entire duration since Kilauea's first post-2018 caldera collapse eruption, we get February 11, 2033. Since the two longest-term averages suggest a 2033 date, that is probably about when the deepest part of Kilauea's 2018 caldera, for all intents and purposes, will essentially cease to exist. What I mean is the 2018 caldera will still exist, but it won't be obvious having been almost entirely, if not entirely, filled with lava in their prior years. It will simply look like Kilauea did pre-2018 collapse. Now, I do want to note that the depth figures I just stated truly are educated guesses, but with a decent amount of supporting math involved. The Hawaiian Volcano Observatory has not been taking sensor measurements of the crater depth since late March of this year. The last lava lake top elevation data they got was 964 meters elevation, which is only 19 meters lower than I interpret it to be today. Yet, what only took less than 48 hours to fill the first 95 meters of the 2018 caldera, it is going to take significantly longer to fill the last 95 meters. And this comes down to simple length and width. The deepest 95 meters of the original 2018 caldera were 312 feet or less wide. Yet, at the present, when lava erupts at Kilauea, it spreads out to a much larger area spanning 7,907 feet wide. While the caldera isn't a perfect circle, if it was, that would mean that it takes 642.27 times more lava to add 1 foot of new elevation today than it did for adding 1 foot new elevation to the crater bottom when the lava had only filled it to 95 meters or 312 feet deep. That is why only 36.3% of the lava necessary to reach the top has erupted since the 2018 collapse, despite it looking deceptively close. The process of a caldera forming due to a large volume flank eruption and then refilling of said area has occurred numerous times throughout the long history of the Kilauea Shield Volcano, most recently in 200 BCE, 1500, and of course, 2018. This is just a friendly reminder of how dynamic the Kilauea Volcano still is. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Holly Bird, for supporting my work.